I'm assuming you waxed your vagina, probably. Like, or are you... I don't know if that's cool anymore. Is it cool? And I'm not asking the men, because I know what you guys, because, like, yeah. Girls, is it still cool to wax your vagina? Yeah, a couple... No, it's not, I don't think. Like, I remember when we had to do it, like, in the late 90s, early 2000s, because, like, that's the only way a guy... I remember the reason I did it was because the guy I had a crush on said, I only dine off a clean plate. Meanwhile, he's growing mushrooms on his balls, and I gotta be... Pardon me? Yee, crazy. I did it anyway, though, because I was a dumb idiot. Like, I was in my 20s. You're dumb when you're in your 20s. So I marched myself down to one of those waxy places, and that was stupid to go by myself. You always bring a girlfriend that's more experienced, right? Because it's an intimidating experience, right? Because I thought there were two styles, the Brazilian and the bikini. But no, there's like 80 styles now. Like, I don't even know how you choose, right? Like, do you want to get the runway so you can strut your stuff? What about the Bermuda Triangle? Don't get lost down there. Swallowed 6 ships last month. Just as real, I have no idea what happened to them. And then they had one, it was edgy. I thought it was funny, but I don't know, some of you guys might be pussies. It was called the Hitler. It was fucking hilarious. It was a Lego block of pubes right at the top of your pussy, come on. That's funny and creative, that's funny and creative. I was tempted to get the Hitler and then buy some googly eyes. Just stick them on down there. Go out. Find myself a nice Jewish boy. Take him back to my place and I'd be like, destroy this man. Now's your chance. Beat the shit out of him for your bubby. Together we will destroy Clitler. Right? Yeah, that is a funny joke. You're right. It feels nice to laugh again too, right? Because sometimes I'm not worried about getting canceled. I don't have a career, so. But sometimes you gotta be so worried, like, what's somebody gonna think? Somebody that has no influence in my life might get upset. Well, I don't know what to tell you. That's a funny fucking joke. If you were offended by that joke, let me just do it. I'm sorry that you're an idiot. Because I didn't say anything good about Hitler. I think it's great that future generations are going to know Hitler as a pubic hairstyle. That was not in his manifesto. That little guy would be so pissed off right now. Oh, my God. We should do this for more shitty people with fragile egos, right? Like, there's one that's easy and obvious, like the Trump. Like, I know he's not really around anymore, but it's too good, right? Like, it's easy. You just grow it out. I'm doing it right now. And then when you want to go out and party, you just moose it up, part it to the side. I like to call that the alt-right, you know? And then you spray tan it orange. Give it a healthy grab. And for the rest of your life, as long as you live, you never let a minority in. Relax, relax. They can still come in and clean it and fix it and maintain it for you. But if you allow them to come inside and build a life, it'll destroy everything we've been working for! Okay, this show is almost over, but I really need to make sure that everyone's clear on this, because that's the thing, you gotta clarify your comments these days or someone's gonna get pissed. So I just want everybody, I don't want anybody leaving here tonight thinking that I don't want minorities in my vagina, okay? That is fake news. I love minorities in my vagina. They're the hardest workers. It's true. One Filipino guy will do the work of 5 white guys in less than an hour. And then his entire family comes over for a picnic. You'll never have a better day. You guys were so much fun. I'm Kathleen McGee. Have a great night.